Okay, so the volume of a pyramid is with a base of area B and height of h is given by the formula. Well, basically, you would have the regular rectangular solid to be the base times the height, and all you have to do because of the pyramid part right here is put a 1/3 in front of it. So 1/3 of the base times the height. Alright, if we want to find the volume of this cube, basically it's a base, the area of the base of the length times width times the height. So we're looking at 7 times 7 times 7, which is 343. Now, just so you know, 7 to the third power is 3 sevenths, and that of course is 343, and that's why they call it 7 cubed. Alright, in this case, we're going to find the volume of this pyramid. So basically, we want to find the volume of the base. So let's start with a capital B here. So the capital B is the volume of the base, which is going to be 2 times 6, which is equal to 12. And then we want to take that and multiply it times the height. So the base times the height is going to be equal to 12 times 10, which is equal to 120. Which then we want to take 1/3 of the base times the height. That's because of the pyramid part, and that's going to be equal to 1/3 of 20, or 120, excuse me, which is equal to 40. And then just don't forget to put the units, which is meters, and then the cubed. Okay, so that's an M right there. Meters cubed. Alright, same idea for this right circular cone. We're going to first take the area of the base. Of course, this time the area of the base is going to be pi times the radius squared because it's a circle. So that's going to be equal to pi times 9 squared, which turns out to be 81 pi. And then we're going to multiply it times the height. So we'll have the base times the height, which is equal to 25 times 81 pi, which turns out to be 2025 times pi. Okay, and then what we're going to want to do is we're going to take 1/3 of that, so 1/3 of the base times height. The 1/3 is because it's a cone, and that becomes 1/3 of 2025 pi, which gives us 675 pi. And you can leave your answer like that. Don't forget to put, oh no, it says to round to the nearest whole number. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so you can see here 675 pi multiplies out to be 2119.5, but it says to round to the nearest whole number that actually rounds up because of the 5, so 2120 feet cubed. Here we have a sphere, and we're going to do the volume. Just remember the formula for the volume of a sphere is 4/3 pi times the radius cubed. So we'll just follow that. We'll have 4/3 times pi times 12 cubed, which is going to be equal to. Okay, so 2304 pi. And then we multiply by 3.14, we get this, and it's just to round to the nearest whole number. In terms of pi, that would be the answer for the first one, and then the nearest whole number would be this one. And don't forget to include the units of meters cubed. All right, finding the surface area of this figure requires us to look at all the different surface areas. So basically, we're going to have, there's going to be a 9 times 6. Write that down, 9 times 6. That's for this side, and there'll be two of those. And then we'll have a 4 times 6, and there'll be, that's a multiplication, and there'll be two of those. Those are multiplication symbols. I know they look a little strange. And then we also have a what, 4 times 9? 4 times 9, and there'll be two of those. When I say two, remember, there's ones on the bottom and top, that's the 4 by 9s, and then the 6 by 4, 6 by 4s, and the 9 by 6s, and 9 by 6s. So we just need to multiply all these out and then just add them all together. And we can do that pretty quickly. So you can can see here, 108 for that multiplication, 48 for this one, 72 for this one. They would just add them up to get 228. Now notice this is area, so it's centimeters squared. All right, for this one, we're actually going to use the volume of this cone right here and the volume of a sphere and cut it in half. And then we're going to see what we can do with the answers. All right, let's start out with the cone. All right, so for the cone, basically what we have to do is remember the formula for the cone. It's an upside down cone, but still a cone. So we have 1/3 the area of the base times the height, which in this case, the base is going to be the circle with radius 9. Let me make a note here that the radius is equal to 9. See that? A half of 17. So we have 1/3 pi times the radius squared, which is 81, times the height, which is 20. And that turns out to be 540 pi. And then we're going to do the sphere, which would be 4/3 pi times the radius cubed, 9 cubed. And remember, there's a 3 down there, by the way, 4/3. And we want to take 1/2 of this because we only have half of the cone in here, of the cubes, sphere. So we'll figure out what that is, and then we'll do 1/2 times 4/3 times pi times 9 cubed. That's going to be, well, that turns out to 2/3. 2/3 pi times 9 cubed, which is 729. That's a funny looking pi. Sorry, that's a pi right there. And that turns out to be, let's see what that is. Okay, so that turned out to be 486 pi. So then we just need to add those two together. So we'll take our 540 pi plus our 486 pi. That's a 4. And we'll just add them together to get, we'll get 1026 pi. And then what we'll do is multiply that times 3.14 to get 3,221.64, which rounds up to 3,222, and that would be centimeters cubed for volume. Right, I said find the volume. Okay, so here's the answer to the exact number in terms of pi. So it would be your first answer right there. Don't forget to include the centimeters cubed as your units, and then this would be the rounded answer right down here. Okay. That should be good for homework number 8.